¿Qué tal, amigos y amigas de Trail Running Review? Estamos aquí en Cegama, un año más como siempre. Ya veis que hace buen día, se prevé mejor clima que el año pasado. De hecho, estuve entrevistando el año pasado a Bart aquí detrás mientras llovía. Hoy podemos estar al aire libre. Y nada, uno de los claros favoritos, de hecho, tenéis la porra y es uno de los votados en la porra también seleccionados como favoritos. Y vamos a preguntarles un poco cómo llega de cara a esta semana. So Bart, I was saying last year we were like just behind us, under the rain. This year, this nice weather, and you were telling me you prefer this kind of weather than really cold weather and muddy conditions.
Yeah, I definitely prefer where we have around 15, 20 degrees. I'm not a runner who like cold weather condition, but I like muddy terrain. It's the place where it's hard for other athletes. For me, it's the better parts. But for me, the problem is when it's cold. So I'm happy the weather we have like this.
Bueno, Bart nos dice que él le gusta cuando hay barro, pero no cuando hace frío, que esta temperatura entre 15 y 17 grados es la que más se siente cómodo, y cuando más difícil es el terreno, eso sí, a él le gusta desenvolverse mejor en estos terrenos más técnicos, obviamente una carrera también que le va bastante de la mano. So Bart, what are you expecting of this race? Last year it was rainy, it was muddy. No Kilian last year. This year with Kilian here and, you know, Manu Merillas and all the good guys. What are you expecting for this edition?
Yeah, last year I was too focused for other athletes, so probably the first part of the race was too fast for me, and the second one was hard to keep the pace with other athletes. This year I will focus only on myself. I will keep my pace, and I hope it will be good results for me.
Pues Bart nos dice que el año pasado salió muy concentrado con los demás y quizá eso hizo que en los primeros compases de la carrera fuera muy rápido y al final obviamente perdiera más el ritmo, y creo recordar que terminó entre una... What was your position last year? It was...
I finished sixth.
Sixth. Yeah. Sexto, más o menos, y que este año prefiere salir a su ritmo y ir viendo. So I remember, I think it was... yeah, maybe 2019, I don't know, with Baronian finishing in the podium, I think. Pretty much together. And it was like picking up guys at the end of the race, going up to Andrade, I think it was. I was following you. So it's pretty much the same strategy. Start in your pace. It's fast, obviously, but in your pace, and then in the end, picking up guys, because Cegama is always a fast course. Yeah. Until the middle of the race, right?
Yeah, it's true. We can see like every year when
Manu Merillas last year,
for me, example, in 2018, 2019, after the first part, I was a 7-8 position, and in the end, I finished in the podium. So probably it's the best strategy for the Cegama race. Mm-hmm. It's a long race. It's a hard race. So you have to have energy for the last downhill to keep the pace until the finish line.
Is it hard to keep your pace like pretty slow in Santo Espíritu with other people? Because I always see you guys running like crazy that going that uphill, and it's like, man, you're probably too fast in this part.
Yeah, it's hard to keep a slow pace in this place.
Espíritu?
In Santo Espíritu. I love this place. I love all climb from Santo Espíritu to Aizkorri.
Yeah.
This is my favorite one. And there is no place for no energy.
Yeah,
people give you a lot of energy, and just you have to enjoy, but relax slower, and after a score you can push hard until the finish line.
Bueno, le he preguntado si es difícil controlar, digamos, ese ritmo más lento que nos decía en Santo Espíritu, donde hay un túnel de gente brutal gritando. Y en la mayoría de casos yo veo, pues, los corredores de delante, incluso los de más atrás, corriendo a un ritmo brutal. Y luego pienso, ¿quieres decir que aquí no estáis gastando? Y él dice que es realmente difícil controlar el ritmo y que es su parte preferida toda la subida hasta la Aizkorri. Y luego a partir de ahí puedes abrir gas hasta el final una vez ha pasado todo el tema de Aizkorri. So Bart, let's talk about, you know, shoes, trail running shoes and stuff like that. You were telling us you are between SLAB Genesis or SLAB Pulsar 3, I think it was.
Yeah.
It depends of the terrain, the conditions.
I, I wait for date tomorrow to see the weather condition. I go running short part to see how looks the terrain in a forest.
Okay.
If it's muddy, probably I will run with Pulsar 3.
Okay.
If terrain will dry, probably I will run with SLAP Genesis.
So, Bart nos dice que está entre dos zapatillas, las SLAP Pulsar 3 o las Genesis, SLAP Genesis. Depende de cómo esté el terreno mañana, decidirá, irá por la parte del bosque, nos ha dicho, y si hay mucho barro con las SLAP Pulsar 3, si hay menos barro con las Genesis. What's the big difference between the SLAP Genesis and the SLAP Pulsar 3? The lugs, the cushioning, the stability?
Yeah, so, you know, if we have muddy terrain, for me, I need big lengths, aggressive grip, to be sure my every step is confident. But if we have a good terrain for running, I need more cushioning for the distance.
Okay.
So for me, it's the big difference between these shoes.
Nos dice que si hay mucho barro, prefiere apostar con taco largo por encima de la amortiguación. Si en cambio está más seco, prefiere amortiguación que no taco por, digamos, la amortiguación en un terreno más seco y que pueda mantener las piernas durante más tiempo. Last question, Bart. Belt or vest? You always with belt, I think?
Yeah. I prefer run with belt.
Okay.
We have a good belt in Salomon. I can run with this bed with
one soft,
one big soft flask.
Okay.
So for me, it's enough and enough place. Also for mandatory equipment, like for a jacket and survival blanket.
Yeah.
Also for GPS, for me, it's enough space to pack all the things.
Pues Bart va a apostar con cinturón. Yo creo que siempre lo he visto con cinturón. No va a salir que tiene un cinturón Salomon suficiente para llevar un soft de 500 y todo el material obligatorio. Finalmente, aquí os dejamos también el enlace de la porra para votar a vuestro favorito, favorita. Ya lo sabéis, tenéis hasta el domingo antes de la carrera y Bart, sin duda, debe estar en vuestra lista. Bart, thank you so much and best of luck on Sunday.
Do you think which position I will finish on Sunday?
Podium for sure. I will go second.
Second?
Second.
Okay.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's good, good.
And what about you, about yourself?
For me, it's important to give 100%, and if I give, I think it will be a good position.
That's good for sure.
Yeah.
Best of luck on Sunday.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank
Gracias.
You. Bart, aquí lo tenéis.